This is from a company called Ecoflow. I have reviewed a few of their models before, and the River 2 Pro is a perfect blend, really, of power output, compact size, and it's got a very good little handhold on it. And it only weighs 7.8 kilos, which is not a bad weight considering it does output 800 watts. It can peak with the X boost mode. They claim up to 1600 watts. Now, we do have a capacity of 768 watt hours, and it will charge very quick, only 70 minutes to fully charge this using AC, of course. And you see down here, I do have some Ecoflow solar panels. Now, this is called their 220 watt bifacial solar panel. So I'll be testing the output of this to see how close to that 220 watts can I get here in the current conditions. And of course, running through a few tests of the River 2 Pro. Now, I just wanted to point out that this is not a sponsored video. I am not being paid by Ecoflow. Now in the box, you will find our charging cable. We have an AC cable for charging it. Now it is very quick, as mentioned, it's only 17 minutes. And here is our car charging cable. Finally, a quick start guide. Now the capacity of this one is 768 watt hours, and that's 40 amp hours. Each of the Type A's is 12 watts each, or a total of 24 watts, and one Type C, which is 100 watts here, that does support power delivery. It's very clear the information we get on the screen. Now, it wouldn't be shimmering like this when you look at it normally. It's just on camera that's happening. So we have our hours remaining battery life percentage right here. We've got the output, the input, all listed, very clear to see this. The DC side of things here, you see it's got its own on and off switch, so that when you power it on, it's very quick, it lights up with the status LED there. Now we've got 126 watts maximum output out of these DC ports here. So we've got our typical cigarette lighter plug there, and these two here support 3 amps each, where the cigarette lighter is 10 amps max. Now all three of the AC ports here do support a maximum of 800 watts, and in total, you can get it up to 1,050 watts of continual use, but it can surge. So the peak output of up to 1,600 watts, which I'll be testing out later on for how long it can actually surge over the 800 on each of these ports here. So the total, just remember that you can pull. So this is from the DC side of things, and the AC is that 1,050 watts. On the right, we've got our fan here. So it does have a BMS, which is the battery management system, plenty of sensors in there. So fan passively cooled, you will hear this come on when it's under heavy load. The plastics they've used here, Ecoflow, very good build quality. But like some others that I have tested out, unfortunately, there is no Qi standard wireless charging pad on the top here, which I would have liked to have seen, because that's a nice option to have, especially if you're lacking the cables. But your phone in emergency situations does support wireless charging, then you could have charged it. Unfortunately, it's not there. I hope they can add it in other models. The left side is where the fan is. You can clearly see it there. And as I said before, like, you will hear it come on now and then, and later on I'll give you a sample of the kind of fan noise you can expect out of the River 2 Pro. Our AC input plug here. So this is for the fast charging. If you want to completely charge that 768 milliamp hour battery, you can do it in just 70 minutes. So it's very quick. And this is our other input there. So this is for the solar or the car charger. And that is 13 amps max. So with solar, it's 220 watts maximum input, which is the same as the solar panels I've got from them, which I'll be testing out. Then the portable solar panel. So this is going to be great for camping, that you could set this up. And I'll show you how to set it up in just a second. But it is a 220 watt solar panel. It's called the Ecoflow 220 watt. It's bifacial, this particular solar panel, has a 23% conversion rate and an IP68 waterproof rating. So this case doubles as our kickstand. Now it's got a hard part to it. So obviously that's the kickstand portion of it. Then we've got those little clips I showed you for the mounting of it to set it up. So this part goes underneath. You need to lift up the solar panel just a bit, get it underneath that. And then the kickstand, I need to lock it on here with this little clip. So I'll just skip the video ahead. I'll set that up now. So I've got all four of them clipped on, and I need to push the panel forward, as you can see, and then get this at the back here to prop up those panels at about a, well, about a 45 degree angle there, of course, angled up towards the sun for maximum efficiency there. So let's see what kind of charging rate I can get out of these 220 watt Bifacial Ecoflow solar panel. So it is currently charging at 192 watts. Here is the peak that I have seen. And if I optimize the angle of the panel a little bit more, I could probably get around 200 watts. For a portable panel, that's not a bad result at all. And it's telling me there's about 20 minutes left to charge the remaining 9%. There are countless uses, of course, for a power station such as this. And one of them is electric power tools. As long as it does not exceed 800 watts, you are good to go. This Bosch line trimmer here is 400 watts, and I should be able to use it for around about 3 hours or so with the River 2 Pro. So I'm going to put it to the test. I'll see how it's going to handle it. It should not be a problem at all, being only 400 watts. Another option is to charge it in your car. So imagine you've got an emergency situation that you have no power in your house, you haven't had power for 2 days, but you've got a full tank of gas in your car, full tank of petrol, diesel, whatever. You can then plug it in, start to charge it, or you're going on a really long journey and you've only got 50% battery and you just want to top it off, then plug it in. So I'll have a look and see what kind of charging rate I can get from my car. All right, so it isn't too bad, 106.7 watts to charge it. And it does tell me it's going to take 22 minutes for me to charge 8% of the battery at that current wattage. Now a bit of a load test. So I have a hairdryer here. On the first setting, I'll test it out and see if we're able to use something like a hairdryer with it. Okay, so the hairdryer is pulling around about 800 watts, 600 at the moment, and that will go for 1 hour. I can see that the fan has come on. I can hear that a little bit. Now we'll step it up to the next level. Pulling 800 watts. Not a problem there, they're 800 watts. And now one more, this is bringing it up to now 1,005 watts. So that's over the 800 peak. But it can in total, they say, do 1,050 watts. So this is looking good. I'll see how long I can do this for. All right, so overload protection just kicked in. That was probably about 40 seconds that I managed to run it over the 800 watts. So that's not too bad. It allows for a little bit of surge there to go over the limit before that kicks in. And it turned off the AC side of things, so it's probably timed out already. Okay, so I can turn that back on now. The fan icon is on. And there we go, AC is working again. Now I'm gonna really overload it just to test out that protection. Will it be able to boil water? So this kettle is gonna pull, I think, well over 1,000 watts. So turning that on now and just unplug the hairdryer, turn on AC, of course. All right, I don't imagine it's gonna go for too long. There we go, 1,017 watts it's pulling now. The fan is on because it, yes, is under load. So that's the active cooling come on. Make sure it doesn't overheat. And it will probably be about the same. This will go for around about 30 seconds or so before it cuts out. Okay, I just heard it go click and it's flashing there, overload. It turned off. Now, if you kept doing this over and over again, eventually you would be able to boil water, but it's not really recommended because you are going over the 800 watts. Then I have it charging. So it's currently charging at about 840 watts and I will load it up again. This is just to test what it's like when it is charging and discharging at the same time. So turn on the AC again and wow, that just clicked out straight away, overload. And it stopped charging and it did stop discharging as well. So it doesn't like to have huge loads over 1,000 watts at the same time that it is charging at around 840. You can see it's gone back now to charging at that 840 watts, but the AC side of things completely turned off. Then what about the fan noise and any heat? Well, I can feel quite a bit of heat coming out of that fan. The fan is constantly on when it is under load or you're charging because it is charging at that high wattage, about 840 watts as we've seen displayed on the screen at least. And here is a sample of what you can expect. It is a little loud when it is charging like this. So it's not gonna be whisper quiet. You will definitely hear it if you're sitting right next to it. The River 2 Pro does have app support and it is called Ecoflow. I'm running it here on Android. So straight away in the first screen, we have a lot of very useful information. So I can see that the available time left is 16 hours and 24 minutes. And this is calculating it in real time off the current output, which is 32 watts. And we've got our input. If I was charging it, that would show other information right here too as well. But the best part is the settings. So there is a lot in here, very useful settings too. So you can see we can share the device with other Ecoflow accounts. You can limit the charging speed if you wanted to do that. You can turn it down. The car input. So instead of 8 amps, you could change that down to 4 if you wanted to. And the DC mode, I just leave this on auto. So solar recharging, car recharging are the two options, but auto seems to work just fine. X boost. So if you didn't want the surge peak of 1600 watts, just disable it. The battery, so you can set the discharge and charge level here. This is a very good setting. So if you didn't want to fully charge it, then you can just put that to say 80% and it will stop there. So that's good. Firmware updates. We've got the specs of it, temperature unit, timeouts here. So the screen timeout, AC timeout, you can set that to there as well. So very handy, straightforward application. So after my testing now of the River 2 Pro, I think it's a decent model here that if you're after a more portable solution, with a decent enough power output to run most garden appliances, most things, 800 watts, and then it can hold and sustain around 1,000 watts as you saw for about 30, 40 seconds. It's not a lot. I'm a little bit disappointed in the peak because I did think the X boost mode would be able to go up to 1,600 watts, but the overload protection kicks in before that. But it's good to see that it does, of course, have the overload protection, overcharge protection. It's got the battery management system with it, of course, so that ensures that it is going to be a safe battery. And I've got no problems having this sitting at home and charging to within my house because I do know that it is safety certified and it is using some quality battery cells, those LFP cells, which are good for about 10 years. The only disadvantages to me of this particular model here, apart from, you know, that can't really peak over about 1,000 watts, is that it doesn't have a Qi wireless charger on the top. I would have liked to have seen that. Sure, we get the 100 watt Type-C port. That is brilliant to have. We get the three AC ports with the 800 watts. Very good again. So all up, if you are looking for a model that is under $1,000, has a good power output, and it's not too large, not too heavy, not too bulky, then take a look at this, the River 2 Pro from Ecoflow.